Okay, so this tutorial is about ball spinning, something that a lot of people find very hard to do. So what I've done is we're on a right-handed table and I have the wheel set up, and what I've done is, if you can have a look at the video here, I've set the two canoes up at the 6 o'clock and 9 o'clock position. When you spin a ball, you will only deal in basically a quarter of the wheel, a quadrant, okay? So we're going to operate, when we're spinning balls, from this position here to this position here. Never further than that. You don't need to reach across, and you don't need to reach right the way around. It should all be in one motion. Now, there's different sized balls you're going to come across in a casino. They may be plastic. They may be a composite, which is a mixture of plastic and ivorine. So it's not ivory, but it's an ivory substitute. They may be small, they may be large. But what you tend to find these days is the casinos are going for the Teflon ball. Now, this Teflon ball's got a coating on it. And as with Teflon equipment that you find in the kitchen, the non-stick stuff, it's exactly the same. The idea behind that is to reduce the friction so that the ball, if you have a look at the two balls, so this is an ivorine ball, as you drop the ball into the wheel, it tends to ping about and it will bounce about. But if you drop the Teflon one, it settles a lot quicker. And this is the problem we have, all right? Is casinos now don't want the ball coming off the rail into the wheel and bouncing about. So you're going to be using the Teflon ball. Now, the reason that's significant is this. Because the friction builds up a lot quicker with the Teflon because of the coating, it will lose velocity a lot faster. So when you spin a ball, that's a normal ball, it will go round and round and round, and you can get a fair look on it. But when you're actually using a Teflon ball, it's a different kind of noise. It will slow down a lot quicker, and it will drop a lot quicker. So that's the one that we're going to be using today. Okay, now when we're ball spinning, the effect we're trying to get, I'll show you on the rim here, okay, is to basically hold the ball between the middle finger and the thumb. All right, and what you're going to be doing is you're going to be looking for, using the running rail here of the wheel, so this area here, this bit, you're going to be using that. That's where the ball goes, okay? So the idea is to take the ball on the running rail and to almost use this finger in a springing motion. So you'll hold it like so against the wood, push your finger against the wood with the ball in this position here, held in place by the thumb, okay? And you're going to use this finger to create a spring. That's where you get your velocity from. At first, when you're doing this, you will move your hand perhaps. What you want to try and avoid doing is trying to use too many fingers, a lot of wrist action, your arm flying out the wheel, possibly hitting somebody in the face, and so on. So the best position to do it is, don't go any further than a quarter point, either side. Use your finger and your thumb against the wheel, and let the finger and the wood create the friction and the spin, okay? So, using the Teflon ball, so all we're gonna do is we're gonna take the wheel. Now, when we spin, we always spin from the last number. So what I'll do is I'll put it in zero because it's obviously an easily to recognize zero, okay? It's green. Now, the first thing you'll do is we always spin in the opposite direction to the wheel, and we always reverse the spins from spin to spin, reverse the wheel from spin to spin. So in this instance, the wheel's finished at zero, it's going that way. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna reverse the wheel, let the ball go past, take the wheel by one of the frets gently, and reverse the wheel. Now, as that ball comes round to you, you need to be able to pick it when it hits this, roughly this quarter here, this canoe. So when it gets in line with that, you want to pick the ball up, get it over into position, and spin it before the zero passes this canoe here. All right? If it goes slightly past, don't worry about it too much. But what you don't want to do is let it go all the way past and keep going past before you spin, because that's what's classified as a no spin. All right, we must always try and spin from the last number. So in very slow motion, I'll bring the wheel round. I'm going to take the ball up onto the wood and spin it before zero crosses that line. All right, obviously in a casino, it may be a little bit faster. So it's almost, the method we use is almost called a pick and flick. So again, I'm going to do it the opposite way this time. So I'm going to take the ball from here, from this canoe here, and I'm going to spin it before zero passes this one here. So you're going to bring it round and you're basically going to pick it and flick it in that quarter of a spin, all right? So So just to recap, we spin the ball with these two fingers only. If you have to use a third finger, fair enough, you may well want to start off with. But you will get a lot more control, a lot more leverage, and a lot more velocity if you use your finger off the wood rather than... A lot of people tend to use this kind of motion, but the problem you have with that is it might judder, it might, you know, drop down. It's not as much control, and you've only got that quarter of a spin to be able to pick it and flick it. Okay? So, I'll just quickly do... So here's it's coming around now. I'm going to pick it up and spin it from there to there in less than a quarter of a spin. And again, the motion is always in those two fingers. If we go the opposite way, I'm going to bring it down, take the ball, before that, again, zero passes, all right? You will find it a lot easier coming across the body this way than you will this way, because you don't have the natural, the leverage in the hand, in the wrist. Here, you can more or less kind of... So if you can have a look, my finger and thumb have got the ball in that position, and my middle finger is going to be using the wood to create that spring. So there's the ball, there's the finger, there's the spring, okay? Coming the other way, it's exactly the same. In that position there, I'm just going to hold it high, let my finger compress against the wood, create that springing motion here, and almost do that with the ball held behind. All right, and that's what we're after. We're after a nice even spin. For a spin to be legitimate, it must go in the opposite direction to the wheel. So if the wheel's going anti-clockwise, the ball goes clockwise, okay? If the wheel goes the other way around, the ball goes the opposite direction. It must go around a minimum of 3 revolutions, the ball, not the wheel, because the wheel will never stop in a casino because it's properly balanced, all right? So the ball needs to go around a minimum 3 times for it to be considered. Now, the trick to ball spinning and the trick to pacing your game is that you need to look at what your customers are doing. In a game where you've got very few customers, maybe 1 or 2, and they're not placing many chips per spin, there's no point in wellying the ball around the wheel because the bets will be done within seconds. So you might want to just say, place your bets, the bets will go down a few spins and then it will drop. That way you'll build up more spin rate per hour and the casino will take more money. All right. If you've got a really busy game, what you don't want to do is what we call spin them off the table. So you don't want to be paying out the last person, picking the ball up and spinning it straight away because none of them will get a chance to place the bets. You tend to find this with a lot of the Asian and the Chinese customers. They will try and wait to place their bets from the point you spin because they seem to think they'll know exactly where you're spinning from and roughly what an idea of where the ball's going to land. It's complete superstition, but it's the way they bet. So if you've got a really heavy game and they're not spinning, they're not betting straight away, then obviously what you need to be able to do is to give that ball a fair lick to give them enough time to place the bets and not spin them off the table. So things to practice then for spinning a ball. Use the running rail. Try and reduce the arc that you're going to use. So try and leave it to a quarter of the wheel. Get into the habit of using your finger as a spring against the wood. It's nicely lacquered. It's nice and smooth. You shouldn't have any problems. Place the ball behind and try and get that nice, even, smooth spin rather than anything that kind of goes da-da-da-da-da. Now, if you're going to call a no-spin, you need to get in and call it straight away. So if, for example, you drop the ball or you don't spin it hard enough or you're not happy, if it's going to go around 3 times, it's a legal spin. So if you do spin it hard enough, don't feel the need to reach in and go, that was rubbish, I can do better, because that's not how we work. Let the ball spin. If it's going to be a no-spin, grab it as quick as you can and announce, no-spin, last number, for example, 0. So if you've taken it out of 0 and spun it, and then you take the ball and you drop it, you shout no spin, grab the ball, last number 0, let it complete a full revolution before then spinning again. All right? We have to let them know, we have to give them notice, we need to be, it's just part of the courtesy of the game, the dealing process. Okay, so there's your position, there's your finger, there's your middle finger, your thumb and your middle finger, sorry, running rail, get that friction, get that motion. Try and let the finger do the talking, or the hand, rather than the wrist. And that's ball spinning. It will be tricky at first. You will find the ball flying everywhere, but it will come. Just focus on keeping your arm straight, using your fingers rather than your wrist, okay? So that kind of motion there, and then you're just going to bring the ball in and use that finger to fire the ball around the wheel. And that's ball spinning, okay?